Hello everyone and welcome to the video. We're going to be going to do a VFR flight today. First VFR flight I've done on Microsoft Flight Simulator, so should be interesting. And the first proper flight I've done in a TBM, so we'll see how this goes. I'll just switch over to the other screen. So you can see here I've already planned out a flight. This is the flight plan log that I use, VFR log. So aircraft is TBM, we've got today's date, our flight time we will do when we finished. Egcc to EG, should be EGNM. So if we have a quick look over on our other screen. Get rid of that and we'll drop over here, switch out all of this, sorry, Navigraph, get rid of that, and this is where we are, EGNL it should be, sorry. So we planned this earlier on, we're going to be going EGCC and it'll be a Fellwall Viaduct departure, then to Lee Flash, Middlebrook Stadium, Winterhill Mass, thinking of Game of Thrones there, then M6 Junction 30, M6 Junction 32, Garstang Marina, which should be a body of water, over to the Fleetwood Golf Course and then across the water going to the channel over here, and we'll be coming in on 05, so we'll join overhead left hand circuit into EGNL. So just switch you back over to this one here. So we've got EGNL, shutdown time we'll put in, landing time we'll put in, brake on time and brakes off time. Elevation, airport data, we've filled this in, so it's going to be a 2-3 right departure. Our VOR is 113.55, which we'll get set in a second. Ground or online, so we've got that there, and the ATIS is there. Departure information we'll fill in when we tune into the ATIS. Frequencies, these are the frequencies that we may need, and the tracks to and from them, so we'll keep that in there just in case we get lost or in case we need it for IFR. All of our departure information here and routing, so altitude our waypoints or towards our waypoints, airspeed, heading and distance, arrival information, altitude of our arrival airport is 44 feet above sea level. Runway is going to be 05. You can't put a 0 in there because it just puts a 5. ILS is none for that particular station, and there is no coverage on Vatsim. ATIS information, we'll get that when we're up. We'll stick the autopilot on for a second and I'll get it off the METAR site. Other than that, we can jump back onto the sim and we'll load it in. So first thing we'll do is we can start getting set up. So I'm already started, so it just sped things up a little bit, and obviously I've pre-filled our stuff in there. PFD settings, we want it decluttered for 2, so we've only got airfields. We've got a range which is okay, we don't want traffic on that. Terrain can be off as well. In fact, we'll stick terrain on, so we're good there. Stick it on relative to us. Data link, weather overlay, we'll put it on and back. Or weather, we can either have weather or terrain, so we'll have weather. That's fine. PFD settings, our bearing is nav 1 and nav 2, which is all good. Other PFC settings, wind should be on number 3, I'm not sure why it says no wind data. Altitude units are in hectopascals. Seem good there. Map range, we can go to 10. Facts for a minute, we can drop it right down to about 2.5. And then we'll change it when we're up. Traffic is set, we don't want traffic. OBS, no. Active nav, FMS, we'll keep it as that for now. If you've got it, why not use it? And sensors, we don't need, we're all good. So that's that set. Now we can come over here, map settings. We've got weather over there, so we'll put that relative to us on here. And then we'll switch it when we're up. Heading map sync, okay. Traffic is on. It's all good. To operate. So that's good. We're all good there. Back. Traffic settings on here is good. We've got a good amount of visibility. Our range on here is 4 nautical miles, so we could probably increase that to about 5 nautical miles. I will go 10, just to be sure. So we've got a good range there. That's all set there. We can go to nav and com, and we'll put the ATIS on. And lo and behold, we've got no ATIS because Manchester's just closed, which is gutting. So, let's have a look. We'll change that to 122.800 and switch it. I was hoping to get some air traffic control there, but well, that's how it goes sometimes. So what we'll do is we'll look at our ATIS. I'll jump you over to this screen here. I'll get the ATIS up. So Manchester has not got any information. Runway is going to be 23 right. Wind direction is, let's have a look. .210 at 3 knots. Visibility is okay. We've got view at 1200. Temperature is, where's your temperature? There we go, 16. 14 for the dew point. QNH is 1017, which will mean the QFE will be 1008.
Manchester traffic via 630 at Gold Pilots. Runway 23 right, 14 mile final.
So that's us filled in there.
I'm at 630 at Gold. What's your speed at the moment?
180 knots for that for Ryanair 630 at Gold.
Alright, Fab, we'll slow down and come in behind you then.
Yeah, no problem, many thanks.
Right, let's change our QNH. Let's see how I can do this, because I've not done it on this one before. PFD, minimums, traffic, PFD settings, speed bug, timers. Let's go on here. Traffic, HMI. Definitely not in here. Where? Oh, there we go, Barrow. Haha. 1017 it was, wasn't it? So Manchester should read 257. There we go. Roughly 240, that's fine. Back, back, and back. So that's set. Oh, good there. We'll go back to the normal screen on here, which is a PFD. Leave it as that. Okay. I'll just change these frequencies because we've not got any on, so that's fine there. Sorry, I should have changed the nav while we were there.
How much traffic is the 43 Mike uniform? We have fully established IMS 238, 14 miles.
Nav and com, audios and radios, nav 1, 1355, enter. That's PFD. We'll just come back over here to this and we'll go PFD settings, other PFD settings. It's not in there. I'm trying to change the HSI, bearing 1, bearing 2, nav 1. Ah, there we go, active nav source localizer. There we go. Let's just see. Our course to 113, if you want to come back, would be 103. So we'll change that to 103. There we go. And then we'll switch it back to FMS. Which is good, so we're set up there. We'll stick our flight director on. We will set our heading bug to 232. Sorry guys, I'm doing this with a honeycomb, so it might be a little bit slower than what some people would expect. Two, three, two. There we go. We're not going to put flight level change and all that stuff in because we are just going to fly it by hand. But it will be, so we'll go 1200, and our speed. We'll put flight level change in, and our speed come up there. And we'd be looking at around about 180, I'd imagine. Like I say, I'm just guessing with this, it's not accurate or anything like that.
Manchester traffic is a 43 Mike uniform with 6 miles out.
Just a traffic, Tomcat 8 Alpha Mike established on the LF 23 right, 12 miles.
So set up there, so if we do need the autopilot, it is tuned in and it's all good for flight level change. Pito eats on, taxi lights are on, parking brake is on, yaw damper's not on, but we'll stick it on a little bit later on. We're all good, I think. I'd say so. Okay. So we're at the business apron. We're going to be taxiing to holding point Mike 1. What I'll do is I'll just give you a little bit of an indication as to what we would expect if we had air traffic control. So if it was me, I'd be stating my intentions and what have you. So it would be a call of Manchester Ground, Golf Bravo Oscar India Lima, which is our call sign. Then we get Golf Bravo Oscar India Lima, pass your message. And I'd say Golf Bravo Oscar India Lima is on the business apron. We are a TVM 930 requesting VFR clearance to Wallasey. Is it Wallasey? Let me just have a look. It's not Wallasey. I should know this because I've got family up here. Walney, sorry. Yeah. Requesting VFR clearance to Walney. Departure to the north via the Fellwall Viaduct. Q&H information, whatever it was, Q&H 1017, and then I'd probably get a call back saying Gulf Bravo Oscar India Lima, clear to start or startup approved. Sorry, it'd be Gulf Bravo Oscar India Lima, startup approved. Call you back with clearance. So I'd read back, startup approved, call you back with clearance. Golf Bravo Oscar India Lima. Now I'm not allowed to prefix my call sign, so my call sign will be Golf India Lima when it's shortened down, but we're not allowed to do that until air traffic control does that for us. So we'd start up and then we'd say Golf Bravo Oscar India Lima ready for taxi, and we'd get the taxi clearance, and we'll either get our clearance when we're taxiing or we'd get our clearance at the hold. So in this case we're going to do it at the hold, so it'd be Gulf Bravo Oscar India Lima, taxi holding point Mike 1 via Alpha, via Alpha, Charlie, Papa, Kilo, Juliet, and I'd read that back. So it'd be taxi holding point Mike 1 via Alpha, Charlie, Papa, Kilo and Juliet, Golf Bravo Oscar India Lima. So initially there's a lot of ATC, and then once we're ready for taxi we'll get down there and there'll be a little bit more. At this point the controller's going to be contacting tower or radar, whichever one he's going to be with, and whichever one's on, because ground can't clear us, it's got to be tower, or if we're doing circuits, or it'll be radar if we're doing a departure, which we're doing a departure. So enough talking, let's get taxiing. Don't know what that's doing. There we go. Not sure what that was doing then, but put a bit of power in. Slow it down a little bit there. So I need to make a call on Unicom here. So I'm going to say Manchester traffic, Golf Bravo Oscar India Lima, taxi and Mike 1 via Alpha, Charlie, Papa, Kilo, Juliet. That's quite interesting, the spray there, because it has been raining at Manchester, so that's pretty good. I feel like I'm cheating a little bit here because I am an X-plane person, I'm an X-plane flyer, but VFR just at the minute isn't right. Oh, here we go. Bunch of grounds on, sorry. No, that's just a Tomjet, so. Oh, yes. Contact me 121.850. Okay. So I'll put on a apologies. Didn't know you were on. We'll move back onto the business apron and we'll get our clearance. So. just so we're not blocking that aircraft that was just there. Because we've seen that coming there. So, parking brake on. Clear that. Navicom. We'll go to comm, sorry. And that'll be 121.85. Oh. Enter. Back and change.
Very good evening to Ryanair 67 Quebec Romeo, requesting departure from to Dublin as filed. Gate 5, Boeing 737-800 with information Alpha 1017.
1067 Romeo ground, Roger, clear Dublin.
So it's information Alpha.
Romeo, squawk 0205.
Services to Dublin, Eclad 1 Romeo 2310205 and Walk 67 Quebec Romeo.
576 Quebec Romeo, thanks, is that correct?
And you've seen something about uniform. Can you just confirm stand 2A or stand 2-6 for us? 2-6. 2-6, thanks.
So?
Subject 4, subject 8 Alpha Mike, taxi 107 via Delta Echo Zulu.
107 via Delta Echo Zulu for subject 8 Alpha Mike.
We'll just wait for a gap in it so we can... so we can make our call. So we're a TBM, we'll just get it right before we do it. So we're a TBM 930, we're on the business apron. We want VFR clearance to Walney. Departing to the north by the Fellwall Viaduct. We've got information Alpha. And QNH is 1017. So let's make our call.
And when I succeed,
hey.
Thank you. Good day, bye-bye.
1-3, Golf, thanks.
Manchester ground, Golf Bravo, Oscar Indy Lima.
Golf Bravo, Oscar Indy Lima, ground for late by specific.
We are at TBM 930 on the business apron, requesting VFR clearance to Walney, departing to the north by the Fellwall Viaduct. Information Alpha, QNH 1017.
Golf India Lima, Roger. I'll cut it back with the start.
Roger, calls back.
I'm ground Qatari 88-1027, request position start. Ground Qatari 88, request position start, 1027.
Qatari 88, sorry, say again.
Spend 27 request, push and start.
Qatari 88, Roger, push and start, non standard push to be a beam limit 2.
Push and start approve A beam limit 2, Qatari 88.
Engulf India Lima, ground.
Golf India Lima, go ahead.
Golf India Lima, you could clear to leave the budget. Of our table wide that's VRP number 1500 VFR QNH 1017 squawk 7360.
Clear to leave the control zone via the Fellwall Viaduct, 1500 feet VFR QNH 1017 and squawk 7360. Golf India Lima.
Golf India Lima, correct. Start approved, report safe taxi.
Start approved, we'll go UK Transport, sorry, Golf India Lima.
I
nearly said my old call sign then.
6-7 correct, grab your 5, push and start a...
So, let's get our squawk put in here. Click on here, and it was 7360. 7360.
Enter. Requesting push and start. Once cleared the EasyJet right from the left, push and start approved to be a leap to be a beam Lima in the cushion to be a beam November Charlie 2.
So in a second we'll make our call for taxi. Should have probably done this in a DA62 because I'm more familiar with a DA62, but hey, we'll jump in a deep end. Manchester Ground, Golf India Lima, ready for taxi.
Golf India Lima, thank you. Taxi Papa 1 via Charlie and Papa.
Papa 1 via Charlie Papa, Golf India Lima. So what I've got in front of me is an iPad, and I've just got a little notepad there, and I'm taking down the notes. So we'll just drop on to our thing. Our breaks off time is 18:33. Parking brake off, and we're going to taxi. So I do need to drop in a response curve, I think that's what you call it, with the pedals, because they're a bit sensitive, which you can see I'm only just touching it there, and we're going quite far. So we're going to be holding Papa 1. I'll just slow it down so that we know where we're going. This should be Papa to our right. Manchester looks so different when you're in VFR.
Contact tower 118.625.
118.625, have a good day, you, Golf India Lima. So we'll go to Papa 1 and then we'll change our frequency. We can do it while we're here, actually. 118.625. We'll get out of the way and we'll hold Papa 1, which is here. Oh, this is Papa 2. Just have a look who's actually controlling on Manchester Tower. It is Darren, so this is interesting. I actually know this person, so I don't know him, but I've spoke to him. He's a controller that was helping with a few things with my S1, so interesting. So here we go. Manchester Tower, Golf India Lima holding Papa 1.
Golf Bravo Oscar India Lima, good evening to you, hold Papa 1 please.
Hold Papa 1, Golf India Lima. So we'll stick our parking brake back on. I don't know don't know why it's not staying on. There we go. We'll stick our landing lights on. So we've got.
Okay, Billy, I'll get you out shortly. I've got two inbound aircraft. The latest is at 7 miles.
Yeah, no problem. Golf India Lima. I think what we could do if is this view just changing a little bit. Camera and zoom, we could do with it leaning a little bit closer, I think. Go to about 40, if we go to 50 as a standard. Let me apply. Right, so that's a little bit better. Can just see everything a little bit clearer then. He said he's got traffic, which is there. I think there was one behind as well. Zoom out a bit, shouldn't I? 777, something like that. You can tell by the engines there. We've got another one over here just coming in. You can see the lights over there.
Welcome to Manchester Bay, take right taxi and hold out 3, contact ground 121, decimal 85, bye bye.
Hold out 3, then contact ground 121, decimal 85, bye bye, contact 667.
Manchester Brown, very good evening to you, sir. Line 067, correct. Romeo taxiing up Juliet is a bottom for a mic inception departure.
Just over 2, Papa Fox, ready clear to land, Romeo 2 to right, your wind's variable at 2 knots.
Clear to land, 2-3, right, Lufthansa, the Papa Fox, hold.
Right, 67 Quebec Romeo, Roger, hold Mike 1.
Hold Mike 1, 67 Quebec Romeo, thank you.
Golfing Delimba, behind the landing, Lufthansa FSA 320 now, short final. 5, Papa 1, line up runway 2 right behind.
Line up behind the 320 landing, Golfing Delimba. So, behind this, we're going to line up. We're all set, everything's done. Let's just double check there it is. So, AP's on, flight
right,
director's in.
Romeo,
so, AP's not on, but it's
on short final.
All set in case we need it.
Right behind. There will be one
flight level change.
Ahead of you.
Landing lights are on.
Ahead behind the landing, Lufthansa 320 Airbus on a short final, runway 23 right. Line up and wait behind.
Lamps are on, strobes
Mike
on.
Rhino 6M, correct, Romeo.
Good, landing needs to go on, so it's on taxi at the minute. So, landing on. Fuel's good, trim's alright, everything's good. There you go. Flaps to take off. Trim needs to come. Needs to change a little bit, so it needs to go down a bit. It's just that's a bit slow, isn't it? I'm spinning this like mad.
To Manchester. Taxi and hold Bravo 2, contact ground 121, that's late 5, bye-bye.
Sorry, we need to go, we need to go.
Taxi Bravo 2, hold Bravo 2, and ground to Lufthansa, to the Fox, bye-bye.
Golfing Delima 5, Papa 1, Eclipse, take it from a 2 to right, your wind's there, a little correction, 230 degrees, 3 knots, right hand turn out.
Clear to land, right hand turn out, sorry, clear to take off, right hand turn out, you, Golfing Delima. Clear to land, eh? What's that about?
Okay. So, we're all set. Power in. See, the rudder pedals aren't liking that. And the stick don't want to go, the stick don't want to go.
Right,
it's going
Romeo
on.
Ready to right.
It don't want to pull up. Oh no. Escape, quick control options. What's going on? Change that to the F-35, apply and save. Let's get up, up we go, there we go. I don't know what happened then. Land the gear up. And... yeah, Roger, we'll check though, sorry, we should be squawking.
You're not at the moment.
Right, I'll tell you what we'll do then. We'll stick the AP on. Let's just change our heading to the heading that we're going now. Tell you what, autopilot. Roger, we're just having a look now. Does that fix a problem? Your damper on. Let's just see if that's fixed stuff for us. Press nav so we know we're going on the AP. Pull back that speed a bit, so we're at 200. Tower, Golf India Lima. Oh my god, what's going on here? Why have we gone? Now we're on COM 2.
Golf India Lima, Manchester Tower.
Tower, Golf India Lima, sorry, I don't know what's going on with this aircraft. Are we squawking Mode Charlie now?
You are squawking Mode Charlie, yes. Report overhead tower, we'll buy that, please.
We'll call, sorry about that.
That's a problem. Technology's going to be a pain in the ass, sometimes.
Right, we need to turn this autopilot off. I need to take over and we need to make a turn over here.
Right, over to you to come now. Thank you very much, Darren. See ya. Cheers, buddy. Control
airspace
now.
Score
conspicuity frequency change approved.
Bye bye. Conspicuity frequency change approved. Thanks for the service. And again, sorry about that.
Don't worry about it,
mate.
It happens. Okay, yeah.
Cheers, you too, mate.
Oh, James, I didn't realise it was you. Otherwise, I was just giving you a hard time. Sorry.
That's Darren there. So,
degrees, Sorry, 8-8 Manchester, very good evening to you, by 900 above in Scandinavian Airport, 320 by Juliet 1, line up runway 2 to right behind.
Clear to line up and wait to runway 23 right behind Qatar 8-8, good evening.
So what I do need to do is I need to just go up conspicuity, so we'll put autopilot on for a second, because we need to sort that out. We'll turn our heading bug over here, so we know that we're going the right way. Right. I don't know why we're on con 2, it doesn't make any sense at all. Why am I listening to COM 2? There we go. On number 1 now, so we want 122.800. Score conspicuity, so 7,000.
Quebec Romeo, flight level 120 for 220.
Right, well, good.
Inbound Delta 254 Mike.
Altitude, let's just have a look what we're doing now. So, we've just gone over Lee Flash, so we want to climb now to 2,500. Put a bit of power in for our climb. And we're looking at 200 knots. So it's there. So Lee Flash was that body of water we've just gone over. We should be coming up to the stadium in a second. So my Doubrook Stadium, I'm going to turn the AP off so I can take control for a sec. It's fine. What's going on there? Let's have a look here. So we should be coming over the stadium in a minute. Doubrook Stadium should just be down there. There it is. There's the stadium. And then we're looking for the mast. So we'll keep climbing for a minute, maintain about 200, and there should be a mast just coming up on our left. Well, the mast would be on this hill here. Keep climbing a little bit. This is Winter Hill Mast, just there. So it's actually quite accurate. That's where the mast would be, just where them buildings are there. And then, according to our thing, we're turning onto a heading of 325. So, what are we? Up a little bit more. And then we're looking for the M6. I'll put the trim down a little bit. Power down a little bit, sorry. Carry on climbing to about 2.5. It's quite good, this. Quite enjoying it. First VFR flight I've done. What I do need to do is I need to sort the trim out for the aileron. Let me just set. I just set the trim on the aileron because it's quite difficult to control. I'm having to keep the stick off to the left. You can see when I let go of it, the
airplane's rolling to the right, so let's just go on here. Shouldn't really do this when you're on Vatsim, it's probably a bad example, especially when I'm training to become a controller. We want to do trim. Ah, what's going on? Go back. Trim. So it's rudder trim. We want elevator aileron trim left. We want elevator aileron trim left. We're going to put in the validate and aileron trim right. We're going to put in there and validate. Cancel that. Apply and save. Open preset manager. Duplicate. TBM 930. Okay. Right, aileron trim right. That's that. Validate and then get rid of that. No, we're not looking for that. We're looking for. Oh my god. That's what we're looking for. Clear validate. We want that to go as well. Clear validate. Apply. There we go. Right. Apologies. Let's get doing what we need to do here. So, a bit more power. Don't know why it cuts the power. Don't know what that's about. So again, trim for speed, power for altitude. You can see there we need a bit more power. I'm going to trim for about 200. And we want to start looking for the M6. So there's the M6 there, just down to our right hand side. So we want to follow that. Should ideally have it on our left hand side. But you can see the M6. Let me just try and trim this up. There we go, that's better. We want to go up, so we're going to elevate. This is the M6 just here, which you can see there. So we want to follow this. And that should take us towards Garstang Marina. So obviously I can go off this, I'm not trying to go off this, I'm trying to hand fly it with a VRP, so we're following the M6 and stuff, because that's what you do in VFR. Give ourselves a little bit more power there, try and maintain 200 while we can climb, want to be at 2500. So obviously the IFR rule is east is odd, west is even, and then you've got VFR which is odd and even plus 500. So you'll be able to see just over the dash there, that will be Garstang Marina. And then we'll be heading over to the golf course, so we'll keep Garstang Marina on our left hand side. This is actually quite good for VFR, this is good. I mean, this is better than X-Plane. I hate to say it, but this is better than X-Plane. X-Plane can't really compete with this. So Garstang Marina is just there. You can see there the M6 carries on up towards Lancaster. We're going to be making a left turn and we're going to be going to the golf course, which is just where this estuary comes in. That's where we're going to be heading. It should be just at the very tip of the estuary. So there's the estuary over here. The estuary is actually over there on our left hand side. We've gone a bit further than we needed to. But it's fine. We need to get down. Jumped up a little bit far there. What we didn't do in all that messing in that faff was change our... So I need to drop a little bit, so I'll pull the power back a little bit so we can drop. What we didn't do is turn our landing lights off, so I want to turn them off. I need to have a look at setting a proper keybind for them. So, right in front of us there, just over the nose, that is what we're aiming for. So, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to change the... nav source for there. I'm going to see if that will change. If we can change the course, we can do. So our course, I'm going to put on our runway heading, which will be 05. So our runway heading is 05, which is there. That gives us an idea of which way we need to be heading towards. And we're going to be joining crosswind. I think. Correct me if I'm wrong, I think it's crosswind. Crosswind, descend dead side. And then into the circuit. So I'm going to drop the power a little bit to about 60%. And then we can start descending. Get to around about... that's a bit of a sharp descent, isn't it? Let's drop it to 70% there. So 050, and then we know now, so I'm being easy for the circuit, that, so if we have 050, we know that's our heading. The arrow's pointing to our runway heading. The tail end of the arrow is pointing to the point that we're going to go downwind. So it's quite easy to have some situational awareness.
just leave that there while I get the meter. So our meter in Egnl. So plane's descending on its own there. Egnl 1016. So we'll change our bar off that, which is 1016. So it's 05, and wind direction is la la la, la. Wind direction is 130.06 knots. Right, let's put a bit more power in now so that we can maintain our altitude. Pull the nose up a bit. Bit more power. There we go. That's fine. So we've filled that in. Okay, we're looking for the airfield. Should be at the end of here. So I'm just going to pull over this way a bit. I'm going to slow the aircraft down now. So we want to be slowing it down to about 150. So I'll pull the speed back, use the trim to slow ourselves down. We can just see the airfield there, 1,000 foot above because it's 40 feet. Know that we're going over the runway here. I'll just come over this way a little bit so that I can see the runway. There we are. So 05 is there. So we know we're on the right runway. We'll turn, we're a little bit low. So we can see there if we've got the arrow as we need it, like that, we know we're going backwards. Sorry, not backwards, but we know we're going the right way. We'll make our turn now. We'll slow it down a little bit more. Only traffic, Golf India Lima joining overhead. Not a very good not a very good camera here. I'll just let her nose dip a little bit much there. Well, what we should be doing is we should be able to see there, and a little bit far away, so we need to get down. Going to pot here, innit? Let's make a so yeah, that'd be going in. So that'd be if we're going in, we're on the dead side now. So, only traffic, Golf India Lima descending dead side. Oh, wait. Go on the runway heading. We can climb a little bit. So let's make our turn. I've probably left it a bit late there because I weren't checking. So 30 degree bank, climbing a bit, losing some speed. Want to be about 1040. So we should be crosswind now. I think it's crosswind. Correct me if I'm wrong, I can't actually remember. And it's hard in the sim when you're trying to perform a circuit and you can't really see anything. Especially when I've not got the camera set up, so. Make our turn now. What I need is some camera set up so I've got a view to the rear left. Because that's what gives me, my turn. Once the airfield's in the rear left, then I can make the turn and know that I'm roughly the correct distance. If you have a look at our left side now, we're quite away from the airfield, but as a general rule of thumb, if the airfield's on the wingtip, which it is, you're not too far off. Golf India, Walney traffic, Golf India Lima downwind. Next one's turning base, and the one after that is turning final. So what we're going to do is we're going to pull the speed back. I'm going to try and trim this out now. We want the speed to come back. Keep an eye on where the airfield is. So bleed the speed off, don't let it nosedive. Turn now. Gear down. Flaps in. Don't let it balloon, which it's trying to do. Speed up. 100 knots. Off the rollout there. Okay, trim down. Airfield's over there. So we can see the runway just over there. That's our runway there. So, going here. A little bit off course. Okay, now we'll start descending. 500 feet a minute roughly. Pull the speed back to try and maintain 100. Make our turn. We should have sort of declared turning base, but now we're turning final. So Walney traffic, Golf India Lima turning final. Runway 05. Speed back, flaps on landing. And we're coming in. I don't know what the landing speed of this is, I'm going to guess about 80. So we're going to have to be on the ground at the threshold. So we'll just drop the speed a little bit. Trim, 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 trim. Flaps are all the way in, that's good. Speed down a little bit, trim, trim, trim. Trim for the speed. Okay, speed off. And we're just gliding in. Someone's just contacted me. brakes on. That is not a bad landing. And we'll turn it. Someone just messaged me there saying nice to see someone other than me using Walney. I've got to say, I'm quite happy with that. I know we had a bad do when we were going in, when we were coming out of Manchester, but as far as landings go, and as far as flying goes, considering I've not flown VFR in God knows how long, and the fact that I've not flown it on Vatsim, that's the first time on Vatsim, it wasn't that bad. And the landing, I'm happy with that. I can't whinge at not landing. Some of the terminology might not be right, and yeah, the circuit was a little bit ropey, but all in all, I mean, the landing was good. I'm happy, considering it was guesswork. So I think I'll definitely be flying this TBM again. I hope you all enjoyed it. It was good for me to do. I'll definitely be doing it again, and definitely in Microsoft, because them VRPs were really good. I'll just message this chat back. Won't be 2 seconds. There we go. So that's us. Hopefully I can get some cameras set up so I can get a proper view of the rear left and what have you. I'll do that over the next couple of days or something, and I can do another flight. But yeah, I'm really happy with that. Happy, happy, happy. What we can do now then is we can fill in our we can fill in our sheet. So our break on time is 19:15. Take landing time was 19:12. Takeoff time was 18:42, I think it was. Start time we should have put that on, but it was already running, so we don't need that. Shutdown time, we can put that time as now. So 19:15. That's all filled in. I'm going to export that, and we'll keep that as our first VFR flight. Job's a good one. What I did have running in the background was a little nav map, so we can have a look and see our circuit. That's not that bad, to be fair. So that's our descent. We joined crosswind here, came down here, over, took a circuit and came in. I'm pretty happy with that, yeah. Quite happy with that. Okay. Can drop it back onto the sim. Yep. Shut down. So throttle's there, drop it over. That's going to reverse, I don't know why it's doing that. There we go. And there we go. Engine's shutting down. What's that? And I don't have a clue what I'm doing at this point, because I've not started it up yet. So I'm guessing that off. Let's just have a look. AP trim off. Turn that off. Fuel is okay. Ignition off. Starter needs to be off. Cabin off. It's off. That can be off. I don't know why that. Okay, you go all the way and it goes off and then it's on. That makes sense. I should have had that on in the first place. Strobes can go off, nav can go off, pulse is off already. We didn't put our landing lights on. It's not good. Again, I need to set that stuff up. Taxi off. That's right, so taxi. Taxi light thing don't work and the landing light doesn't work, so I'll have to look into that. Parking brake is on, pitot heat can go off. Again, that's the caution, we can clear them. Look down here, all this is off, parking brake's on, cabin lights is off. Bleed. Off. Worry about that. Standby. Enter, that's okay. Oh, that's fine. Down here is fine. Fuel can go off. That's us. There we are. Battery system off, sorry. That's the aircraft shut down. Let's have an external view of it. It's quite a nice aircraft, this. That's us. Just have a look if I've got the drone camera showcase. Let's have a look if I've set that up properly. Yeah, there we go. Half are up, that's it. There we go. Look at that, eh? Have a quick look at the tower view. Let's go. I can't remember what it is to go down. Or to go up. Can't remember what it is to come down. What we'll do is we'll just go here and we'll go forward. Oh no, that doesn't work. In. Is it hard to go up? It weren't that. Ah, no way. Control. It won't be on that, it's on keyboard. And drone up and drone down. F. Don't know what that's about. There we go. Bit of a tower view here of Walney. Quite nice. A nice little place to work. Nice view there. Nice and sunny. Good day for a VFR flight. But just in time, because we missed the storm at Manchester. Okie dokie. Well, I'll leave it on that view, because that's probably the best. You can see our TBM there, and we can see the scenery. Thanks for watching the video. If obviously it's pre-recorded, so I appreciate you tuning in and having a look, and hopefully there'll be a few more. Thanks a lot, everyone.
Understand, how did we ever end up in these crazy times? Don't you feel like we should make a stand if it got out of hand? And I'd say, haven't we all had enough? Damn near ready to fall, ashes to dust. These are crazy times, you know this heart of mine. I'm pretty sure it's gonna fall with all the crazy things we're told. I'd say, haven't we all had enough? Damn near ready to fall, ashes to dust. And when we open our eyes, it's back to the lies until we believe them. And these are trying times. And